Hello, my friends. I hope you all had an amazing week. We are kicking off a new month, and our theme is called Jump, Jump. What animals do you think about when you think about animals that jump? I think of these two animals. Which one is this? Yes, it's a frog. And how about this one? Yep, a kangaroo. Do you like to jump? I think we should practice jumping right now. What do you think? Okay, so I'm going to put a 10-second countdown on the screen, and I want you to jump around like a frog or a kangaroo and see how high you can jump. So stand up. Okay, ready? Set. Go!
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Way to go! So, we all have to make choices every day, right? Some choices are easy, like eating an apple instead of a banana. But there are some choices that are harder to make, and that's when we can turn to God to help us know which decision to make or which way to go. So this month, we are learning to jump, jump, and go God's way, because God's way is perfect. Last month's memory verse was pretty long, so don't worry, this month it is much shorter. And it says, God's way is perfect, 2 Samuel 22:31. Let's learn the hand motions, shall we? Here we go.
God's way is perfect. 2 Samuel 22:31. God's way is perfect. 2 Samuel 22:31.
Great job learning those hand motions. Guess what? It's time for another memory verse contest. You just need to have someone video you saying the verse by memory and have them email me at dana@hopepd.org. And your name will be put into a raffle to be revealed on the last Sunday of the month. Dylan will be announcing what the prize will be next week on HKGN. Okay, so it's time for our Bible story. Today we go to the Garden of Eden. This is when God introduces us to Himself and His perfect plan. We will explore how perfect everything was, from the flowers and the food that grew to the amazing animals that Adam got to name. Let's go to the clubhouse and take a look.
Who? Who? You know what time it is?
Time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning to.
Happy to see you today. It is such a beautiful day outside. I wanted to practice going on my pogo stick, but I broke my arm. So I went to the park with my aunt. I felt so bouncy, like a kangaroo. I jumped and I jumped, and I saw beautiful flowers and big green trees. It was so pretty.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie!
Hello, Zoe. Who? Who? Jumping all around, are you?
I am, Ollie. I got to see so many beautiful flowers at the park with my aunt.
The park is lovely. It's true. I know an even more amazing place for you. Listen to this story. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through.
Oh, hi, friends. Hola. I'm Luis, the handyman. Today, I'm watering all the seeds I just planted in my little garden here. I'm growing tomatoes right here. And over here, I'm planting strawberries. And then this spot is going to have peppers. Very spicy. You know, this garden reminds me of our story today. Do you want to help me build it? Great! All right, let's put it on the story fence. Hammers up, little builders. Ready? Uno, dos, tres, hammer! Great job, little helpers. You can put your hammers down. Now we just need our story tools. Yep, we have everything we need. Today's true story from the Bible begins in the very beginning, when God created the most perfect garden. It had big trees, beautiful flowers, and lots of plants. Some of them even had food on them. And there were so many animals. Look at this place. I told you it was perfect. And God made it all. But he wasn't done. As beautiful and perfect as the garden was, God knew it needed his most amazing creation. So God made people. He called the man Adam. Now wave to the kids, Adam. And the woman was called Eve. Now the garden truly was perfect. God gave Adam an important job to do. God told him to name all the animals and take care of them. Let's see if you know the names of these animals. Ready? What's this guy's name? Yeah, frog, that's right. Okay, who is this? Yes, it's a bunny rabbit. Okay, now this one is harder. Ready? What's his name? Yes, he's a kangaroo. Boinky, boinky. Great job. So, Adam and Eve lived in God's wonderful garden, and they knew that God's way is perfect. They could eat fruit from any of the trees, except for one. In fact, that was the only rule. God told them to never, ever, ever, ever eat that one fruit. Oh no! What are they doing? Is Eve going to eat the fruit? Everybody say, oh no! Ready? Oh no! No! Eve ate the fruit! Wait! Now what is she doing? She's handing it to Adam. Everybody say, oh no! Ready? Oh no! No! They both ate the fruit. They disobeyed God. And because they didn't do the things God's way, God had to send them away from his beautiful garden. God still loved Adam and Eve very much. They still had food to eat and animals to take care of, but everything was a lot harder. It would have been so much better if they had followed God's way. Because remember, God's way is perfect. When God wants you to do something, remember, his way is perfect. So jump, jump, and go God's way. Hey there, Holly. Tell me, whose way is perfect?
God's way is perfect. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, whose way is perfect?
God's way is perfect. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. Adios!
So there's your story. And it's all true. God made a beautiful garden because his way is perfect. Ho! Ho!
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Ho! Ho!
It's amazing! God made such a beautiful garden. It was perfect! Because God's way is perfect! I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! I'm going to jump around out. outside and go find more beautiful things God made. I'll see you next time. Bye!
God has a way of doing things, and it works out best for us when we choose to trust that God's way is perfect. You ready for this month's question? Okay, so when I ask you, whose way is perfect? You say, God's way is perfect. Let's try it. Whose way is perfect? Yes, God's way is perfect. Now let's sing this month's worship song. Stand to your feet. Here we go.
God, you are the best. You don't make mistakes. Yeah, you don't make mistakes. And when things are a mess, you always know.
Is that you would remember that God has a plan for you and His way is perfect. Let's pray. Get those hands ready. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Give a little clap. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Fold them in your lap. Dear God, we thank you for another week where we get to learn about you. And I just pray that we would learn to follow you and trust in you, and that we would be ready to jump, jump, and go, and know that you have a perfect plan for us, and you will guide and direct us as we have to make decisions in life. We love you, we trust you, and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great week, everybody.